There was a recent election in the Durham region in Ontario, and the Conservatives won. Pierre's new guy takes his first at-bat today. But before we get into it, I want to encourage everyone to smash the like button, subscribe if you haven't yet already. It does really help grow the channel. Once you are subscribed, I really appreciate it if you smash that bell notification so you can actually be notified of upcoming videos. Sit back, relax, and watch the new guy take his first at-bat.
Member for Durham.
Hey, new guy! Drop some W's in the chat, everybody. Look alive. Look alive. Let's go. You know,
Mr. Speaker, Durham Region is home to many millennials who dream of owning a house one day. For 8 years, this Prime Minister has been promising affordable housing, and yet things are only getting worse. Millennials know this Prime Minister is not worth the cost. The Liberal NDP government continues to announce expensive photo ops in the lead up to the federal budget. But we know, as millennials, that we deserve better.
That's right.
How can we ever believe any of these broken promises from the Liberal NDP government again?
Hey, there you go. First time on. That was good. That was good.
Infrastructure and housing.
Mr. Speaker, my sincere congratulations to our newest colleague in the House of Commons. It's wonderful to have you here. What he may not realize,
Mr. Speaker, being new
to the House, is that his leader is actively campaigning on commitments to build fewer homes than we are already projected to build. He may not realize that the Conservative leader has promised to raise taxes on home building. He may not realize the Conservative leader has pledged to cut funding for home building. And he may not realize that his party held a press conference last week to say that they don't want to do anything on municipal reforms and have decided to side with the NIMBYs. Mr. Speaker, over his time here, I hope he comes to see the light and gets with a plan that will build more homes.
Here, here. The Honourable Member for...
Next up, we have Leslyn Lewis, who's been a little bit shaky in terms of her appearances on the House floor. She used to stutter. She didn't really have her talking points in order, but she has improved significantly. And today, she just takes the Liberals for a ride. Here is the clip.
Government, cost of living is out of control. Farmers are suffering and food has become unaffordable because of the carbon tax. Almost 2 million Canadians are going to the food bank every single month. Yet on April 1st, the Liberal NDP government increased the carbon tax by 23%. Will this Prime Minister stop punishing Canadians and farmers and pass Bill 234 in its original form?
The Honourable Minister of Natural Resources.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I do think that it's time that the Conservative Party stop trying to mislead Canadians. The price on pollution is an effective mechanism for reducing carbon emissions, and 8 out of 10 Canadian families get more money back, a fact that was underlined by 200 economists across this country that said it is the most efficient and most effective way to reduce emissions that ensures we address affordability. And in fact, Saskatchewan Premier Scott Moe last week said he explored alternatives to carbon price, but he found they were too expensive. Well, my goodness, we've been saying that for years.
I didn't know the Liberals could yell.
Canadians can't afford to live because of the carbon tax. Common sense Conservatives will axe the tax, build the homes, fix the budget, and stop the crime. After 8 years of this Liberal NDP government, rent and mortgages have doubled. The Liberal NDP government is just not worth the cost or the corruption. Will this Prime Minister commit to immediately passing Bill 234 in its original form, cancel the carbon tax, and once again make life affordable for Canadians?
The Honourable Minister of Natural Resources.
This is the fundamental problem with this remade Conservative Party, where policy is based on ideology and ignores all of the facts. 200 economists from across this country underline that the price on pollution enhances affordability for those on modest incomes and addresses climate change in an effective manner. Even Scott Moe and Daniel Smith have said that. And these folks sit on their hands, these climate-denying Conservatives. It is time they listen to people who actually know what they're talking about and abandon their plan to simply let the planet burn.
Next up, we have female versus female. One has logic, the other one doesn't. I'll leave it up to you to decide which one does and which one doesn't. Sit back, relax, and enjoy this clip.
Mr. Speaker, after 8 years of this NDP Liberal government, Canadians cannot achieve their goal of owning a home and continue to struggle amidst this crisis. According to a recent report in the Globe and Mail, Canada needs to complete 320,000 housing units annually from now until 2030 to meet the demand. Canadians have had enough and must see this crisis managed properly. This Prime Minister is not worth the cost nor the corruption. Will the Prime Minister stop basing this budget on bureaucracy and photo ops and actually build the homes?
The Honourable Minister of Families.
Mr. Speaker, quite the contrary. You know, I have the opportunity to speak with many mums and dads across this country about the programs that we've been putting in place to support them. I recently spoke to Chris, who lives in Peterborough. She's a Trent University student. She shared the impact of our waiving of the interest on student loans. She shared the impact of being able to access $10 a day childcare, as well as the Canada Child Benefit. These programs have saved her tremendously and helped her and her daughter get ahead.
Member for Elgin, Middlesex, London.
But Canadians need a home, and Canada has not built any more fewer homes than we did in back in the 1970s, where our population was half of what it is today. We need 320,000 units being built before 2030. This requires a record pace of construction, which will already exhaust an already burnt out workforce. Canadians need solutions. This Prime Minister is not worth the cost. Will this Prime Minister stop making announcements and just get the houses built?
The Honourable Minister of Housing.
Stanley. What helps mums and dads across this country afford a home, Mr. Speaker? Being able to have access to $10 a day childcare and get back into the workforce. We're seeing record numbers of women, of moms, get back into the workforce, giving them the opportunity to contribute to their family finances and be able to afford a safe place to live. Contrast that to the Conservatives' continued fear-mongering. On this side of the House, we're doing the hard work to support families.
That's right.
That's the end of the video, folks. I hope you enjoyed it. On our way out, I'd really like to encourage you guys to smash the like button, subscribe if you haven't yet already, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.